I think I see the chick in the nest.
This is Laura Francoeur. She's the chief wildlife biologist for the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. She's been managing wildlife at airports for over 20 years.
It's made a nest in the light pole up there.
Here at New York's John F. Kennedy International Airport, she says birds are the wildlife group most frequently struck by aircrafts.
We're located right on Jamaica Bay. There's a lot of water resources around us, and that's very attractive to bird populations, especially shorebirds and waterfowl.
And if these animals find their way onto the runway, it could create a problem for aircrafts taking off and landing. So Francoeur is here to explain why wildlife strikes can be dangerous, how to mitigate them, and what steps are taken after a collision to make sure your flight lands safely.
A strike occurs when there's been wildlife that strikes an aircraft and that's been witnessed by someone, whether that's a pilot, airline crew, or someone on the ground, or if there's damage to the aircraft, or if there is a carcass of wildlife that's found on the ground in the runway environment.
On average, 47 strikes are reported daily, and in 2020, 94% of them involved birds.
Most wildlife strikes are going to occur during departure or arrival. And the reason for that is they're sort of in a low flight phase. So the aircraft are lower to the ground, so they're more likely to strike wildlife.
Francoeur says most strikes don't result in any damage to the aircraft, and the ones that do range in severity.
It could be the light on the landing gear is broken, so it could be very minor, or it could be much more serious, such as an engine ingestion and they have to replace an entire engine, or the radome on the aircraft, which is sort of in the nose of an aircraft, and there's a lot of very expensive avionics components that are in there.
Repairing these types of damages isn't cheap. In 2020, for example, the cost of wildlife strikes to the U.S. civil aviation industry was projected to be $124 million and at least 75,000 hours of aircraft downtime.
A little delay in New York, like a 15-minute delay, can cause a ripple across the whole air traffic system, and we're aware of that. So that's our goal, is to try and keep everything moving and as safe as possible.
Airports are on especially high alert for strikes in the late summer and fall because of bird migrations.
It's not just the movement of the birds, which you get in the spring migration also, but the fact that now you're getting naive birds that are flying for the first time, they've just fledged that summer.
During this time, there could be a strike every day or even multiple strikes a day.
Everything is looking for food, cover, and water. So that's your first goal, is to eliminate or reduce the food and cover and water that's available in the airport. And so habitat management is your go-to first stop for that. And it's the best long-term strategy that you can use for managing wildlife on an airport.
One example of habitat management, cutting grass to a specific height.
If you have grass that's too short, there's a lot of birds that like open areas so that they can see the predators around them. So you will attract those species. And then if you have the grass height too tall and when it's more unmanaged, you might get a lot of small mammals, rabbits, and other kind of medium-sized mammals that are actually hiding in the grass. And that potentially can attract larger raptors, hawks.
This is an anti-perching device, another form of habitat management.
And you can see that it has a pointy cap on that. We worked with different shapes. This was the winner here, and actually no birds perch on those anymore.
Wildlife management staff also patrol the airfield every day, looking for holes underneath fences where wildlife can get through, nests on airport structures, and ponding if there's been heavy rain or snow.
We're managing everything from insects, spraying pesticides, and making sure that we're not having wildlife such as raccoons, possums, starlings, pigeons attracted to dumpsters.
And sometimes they'll use tools like this to disperse birds from the runway.
Pyrotechnics is one of the most common ones. It provides both a visual and an auditory component that will scare wildlife off the airport. Even simple things like honking the horn on our vehicle or just driving with the vehicle will flush a lot of birds right off the airport.
Traps are also set up around the airfield to catch starlings and pigeons, which in addition to being hazards to aircraft, can also draw in raptors and other birds as a prey source.
They'll go after the bait that's up here. They think that there might be more bait down below, and so they'll drop down this tube. It makes it very difficult for them to fly straight back up.
Some species, like this American kestrel, are released at least 30 miles from the airport with a numbered band around their leg.
From that, we get good data on, is that bird staying away from the airport? Is it hanging around?
So what happens when there is a strike?
If a pilot calls in that they had a strike on departure or arrival, the first thing we're gonna do is send someone out to inspect that runway. If it's an aircraft that's on departure, we may reach out to the airport that they're headed towards and let them know that there's an aircraft coming in that had a strike and to please collect the snarge.
This is snarge, the remains of a bird after a strike.
This is all that's left from this strike, but it's clearly a snowy owl. And this is where we put all the wildlife remains that we find out in the airfield while we're completing the strike reports.
Sometimes when it's a very small amount of material, it can be difficult to identify the species.
So a sample of this will be sent to the Smithsonian Institution's Feather ID Lab for identification, and they'll be able to identify the species for us.
Qualified maintenance teams also review most bird strikes for any damage. If the damage is minor, like a broken light lens cap, it can be quickly repaired between flights. But if it's more severe, or if snarge needs to be cleaned off multiple parts of the aircraft, for example, this can lead to delays or canceled flights.
Our goal in wildlife is not just the safety of the airport, that's the main thing, but also we want to make sure that we're not impacting airport operations. So even if you do have some sort of strike that doesn't cause damage, we want those aircraft to continue moving and we don't want to disrupt air traffic.
Clearance, JetBlue 9904.
To ensure that your flight takes off and lands safely and on time, wildlife management teams run diverse programs year-round to target the airport's unique wildlife population.
If we're doing our job well, you don't notice us at all, and we should be silent and hidden and invisible to the average traveler.
Unless you happen to be hanging out with a flock of birds.